हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू दी मोटर टॉर्शन। तो आज हमारे साथ है आशीष जी, जो कि हैं पेट्रोल टर्बो डीसीटी क्रेटा के ओनर, और हम करने जा रहे हैं उनके साथ इस गाड़ी का ओनर रिव्यू, और आपको बताएंगे कि क्या है इस गाड़ी में पॉजिटिव, इसके नेगेटिव्स और बेस्ट चीज़ें इस गाड़ी की हम आपको बताएंगे। तो सर, वीडियो स्टार्ट करने से पहले हेलो कह दीजिए हमारे।
हाय फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड स्टार्ट विद थैंकिंग मोटर टॉर्शन टू टेक दिस रिव्यू विद मी, and I urge everyone to have basically like or subscribe this particular channel, because they are giving very right content to the customers who are willing to buy the new motor vehicles. Sachin,
thank you for coming on our channel.
So
start karte hain sabse pehle. To sir, आपके पास ये कौन सा वेरिएंट है और क्या ऑन रोड प्राइस आपको पड़ा था इस गाड़ी में? और मैं आपको बता दूं कि हम हरियाणा के सिरसा में हैं, तो ऑन रोड प्राइसेस इस हरियाणा के बेसिस पे कैलकुलेटेड होंगे। तो सर क्या है?
सो बेसिकली मेरे पास क्रेटा SXO वेरिएंट है। सो SXO हैज टू ऑप्शंस, या तो आप टर्बो डीसीटी ले सकते हैं विच इज ड्यूल टर्बो चार्ज इंजन 1.4 टर्बो, और या फिर आप IVT की तरफ जा सकते हैं। सो IVT इज अनदर मैनुअल ऑटोमेटिक ट्रांसमिशन बाय Hyundai। सो मैं जो वेरिएंट आई वाज एस्पायरिंग फॉर, दैट वाज पेट्रोल IVT, बट ड्यू टू द लॉकडाउन और ड्यू टू द लिमिटेड स्टॉक्स अराउंड द कंट्री, सो आई हैव गोन फॉर टर्बो DCT। सो दिस ऑन रोड प्राइस फॉर दिस व्हीकल वाज अराउंड 19.5 लाख। सो व्हीकल प्राइस वाज अराउंड 17.2।
ओके ग्रेट। तो जब आपने ये गाड़ी खरीदी तो आपने और काफ़ी गाड़ियों के साथ टेस्ट ड्राइव किया होगा, कंपैरिजन किया होगा, क्योंकि आप मतलब अपनी हार्ड अर्न मनी को स्पेंड करने चाह रहे हैं, तो आपने किस किस के साथ कंपैरिजन किया और क्रेटा का ही आपका क्यों प्लान बना?
सो बेसिकली सो आई वाज अवे फ्रॉम इंडिया फॉर सम टाइम नाउ। सो एज सून एज आई लैंडेड बैक टू इंडिया, सो आई वॉज विलिंग टू बाई अ कार, बिकॉज आई वॉज नॉट हैविंग एनी व्हीकल एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम। So the first thing in my mind was to have an automatic car, because of I drove automatic cars in other countries. So that was first and foremost choice. Then I was in impression of buying a Kia or a Hyundai or a Jeep vehicle. So these were three comparisons I was doing. So I took a test drive of Kia Seltos. So it was a manual transmission which I have taken. So the drive was good, the features were good, so Kia also had a good product. But when I came and have a look on the Hyundai Creta, so my interest got changed. So I saw ki jo Creta hai, that is much better than Seltos in some areas. Of course both has their edge, but still Creta has some which I like personally. And then my family also wanted me to have a product which is more established in this market. So Kia is a new brand in this country. They are doing very good. I wish them success. But still, this is my fifth Hyundai product in my family personally. So I started with Centro. Then I took Grand i10. That was my first car. Then from there I took i20. So then we took basically my brother took Venue as well.
Okay.
So and then we have Creta now. So this is our fifth product in our family, and we had that kind of comfort with Hyundai over a period of time. So yes, that helped me to make my decision to buy this vehicle.
Okay.
So the second comparison was basically Jeep Compass. So So we don't have a local dealership here as of now. So I had to go to nearby city to have a drive review, but we could not go because I saw that there are certain issues with Jeep in this country as of now. So the service quality is not up to the regular customer standards. Secondly, the model which I liked, that was going beyond my budget. So that was around 25 lakh. And third thing, I think which Hyundai has, which other cars don't have, that they come up with a lot of features. So Compass didn't have those features. So that is why we finally made this choice that we'll go with Creta only.
Okay. तो अब जैसे कि ये DCT वेरिएंट है तो हमने सुना है कि सेल्टोस जो कि इसी की सिबलिंग है तो उसमें कहीं ना कहीं यूजर्स को हीटिंग इश्यूज आए थे, तो कहीं आपको ऐसा फील हुआ कि इस गाड़ी में भी हीटिंग इश्यू आपको लगा हो ट्रैफिक में या हाईवे पे?
सो विद माई 2 months ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस आई डिड नॉट हैव दिस इशू. या आई मीन आई हैव सीन दोज वीडियोज और कॉन्टेंट ऑनलाइन दैट द ओनर ऑफ किया हैज फेस दीज इशूज इन द कार. But still, I have seen the recommendations also by Hyundai, and even they have given one document along with this vehicle that whenever you drive a DCT car or automatic car, so you have to follow certain norms which every customer should do. So one, whenever we stop our car anywhere while driving, so make sure we shift our gear lever to neutral. So that is one common practice. Second, we have to have some sort of gap when we drive between the cities. So it should not be bumper to bumper touch. We should have that kind of gap between the vehicles, because sometimes those basically the output of other vehicle get other vehicle transmission heated. And then you should not have the rapid acceleration. That is another point I've heard, that whenever you do the rapid acceleration, then transmission gets heated. So yeah, these 3-4 things are there which every customer must follow to have their transmission neutralized.
Okay, fine. So, आपको actual mileage क्या मिल रही है इस गाड़ी से?
So mileage is a big worry for me as of now. So that's the only point I could see.
Okay.
So city mileage is not up to the mark. Even we have Venue in our home, so. Hyundai petrol cars have mileage issue. That is my first and foremost point. So I had Grand i10, which was a petrol variant.
Okay.
So in that vehicle also I was getting a mileage of 9 to 10 km per liter. In this car I'm getting a mileage of 6 to 7 in city. When I go for a long drive on the highways like 200, 300 kilometers, then yes, I'm getting of 16 plus, around 17 I got in my first drive. And if I go for let's say 15, 20 kilometers outskirt of the city, then I get around 11 to 12 kilometer per liter. So highway mileage is good. It's up to the expectation I had, but city mileage is very poor, and I will definitely report this to Hyundai as well.
Okay, तो ये जो आपको highway mileage आपने आपको मिली है, तो during this आपने किस mode में ज़्यादा drive किया था? ताकि
my city drive is mostly in economic mode, eco mode we call, and highway I drove in a comfort mode when I had my first drive from the dealership to my city. So I basically got this vehicle from Panipat, which is another district Haryana, which is around 250 km away from Sirsa. So I drove in comfort mode, so I got a mileage of 17 per liter, and city driving I'm getting around 7 to 8. And
तो ये जो माइलेज आपको मिली है, ये आपने एक्चुअल में भी चेक किया कि जो मीटर वाली माइलेज है और जो आपने फ्यूल फिल करवाया?
I think they are more or less same. So whenever I so let's take an example. I get the filling done for 2000 Indian rupees. So we generally get around 25 liters. So on an average, I am driving this car for 25 liter around 200 kilometers or 180 kilometers. So which comes around 7 to 8 kilometer per liter.
Okay. क्या आपको लगा कि इंजन से जो नॉइस है वो ज्यादा है, या हाईवे पे जब आप ड्राइव कर रहे हैं तो जो कैबिन में रोड साइड जो नॉइस होती है जो टायर्स की, वो कहीं आपको फील हुई कि ज्यादा है कहीं?
आई डोंट थिंक आई फेल्ट दैट. सो एज वी नो दैट दिस इज अ टर्बोचार्ज इंजन, सो वी हैव दैट इंजन नॉइस. सो इट्स स्लाइटली यू से हैवियर देन एनी अदर नॉर्मल पेट्रोल व्हीकल. But yeah, this is turbo engine, so we expect that kind of noise to get that kind of vibe also from the engine. Roadside voice, yeah, I never felt that. So there is no noise as such. On the highway also, I have not felt that there is a voice while driving this car. So far it's good.
Okay, so generally, jaise ki 3 driving modes hai, to aapko kis mode mein sabse zyada acha lagta hai gaadi chalana?
Yeah, so from if you see from city point of view, eco mode is good. So this is not like any other eco model, eco mode of the car, because it has good thrust in the engine. So it gives a good acceleration. So itna lag bhi nahi hai if you drive in the city, because our city is not that big as compared to other metro cities. So itna feel nahi hoga aapko. You will not feel that kind of lag. Comfort, yeah, I drove in comfort mode, around 400 kilometers I drove in comfort mode. That was also good, slightly better than eco. Sport mode, I drive out of my curiosity to check how it performs, so it's amazing. So you see the instant acceleration I get from the engine, and so Hyundai also claim that you can also reach 100 kilometer speed in 9.3 seconds. So that kind of claims are there. I've never tried it, yeah, but we will also record that kind of experience as well.
Yeah, sure. Okay. And आपको इसके auto hold and cruise control जो features हैं वो कैसे लगे?
Yeah, so auto hold is again a good feature. So when you basically it is used when you drive uphill. So that is the main point of having the auto hold function. But okay. Yeah, in city also you can use this feature.
Okay.
Because whenever you park your vehicle during the red light or something, so just click that button, and so it will basically hold your vehicle, and as soon as you accelerate, it automatically gets off.
Okay.
So meaning it basically don't allow your vehicle to move when you don't want to. And then as soon as you accelerate, it will take off from there.
Okay.
So when you go uphill, it is very useful, because you will feel that your car is going down because of that uphill movement. So you can keep using this feature.
Okay. और म्यूजिक सिस्टम की अगर यहाँ बात करें तो म्यूजिक सिस्टम का कहीं आपको लगा कि टच में लैग है?
सो स्क्रीन इज बेसिकली टच स्क्रीन इज अमेजिंग. आल्सो इट हैज 8 speaker Bose surround system as well. It has a subwoofer in front, and then it has an extra speaker in the boot as well. So music quality is amazing. We know Bose has that kind of brand recognition in the market.
Suspension ki baat kare to suspension system aapko kaisa laga?
Yeah, so suspension is I think on the better side. I have not compared with any rival as of now, or I've not heard any feedback. But okay. Yeah, you feel that kind of that inexperience in the cabin when okay. you get the portholes on your road.
Okay.
But yeah, it's still fine. I mean, I've not okay. experienced it much.
Okay, fine.
So that's fine.
Okay.
So luckily our roads yeah. are good. City roads are good, so I've not felt that much.
Yeah. ओके सो आपको सबसे अच्छा इस गाड़ी में क्या लगा, और एक नेगेटिव जो आपको मिसिंग लगता है कि शायद होना चाहिए?
या या ऑफ कोर्स. सो आई थिंक पैनोरामिक सनरूफ इज अ वाओ फैक्टर इन दिस कार. आई थिंक व्हाई अदर पीपल्स आर गोइंग विद दिस कार बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पैनोरामिक सनरूफ, बिकॉज सेल्टोस डजंट हैव दिस एंड जीप कॉम्पस हैव, बट स्टिल इट गोज वेरी प्राइजी देन दिस वन. So it goes around 25 lakhs when we go with the panoramic sunroof variant. Second thing, I think the auto hold feature which it has, although Seltos have it, so it's again a good feature to use. Electric parking brake, it is very useful feature, so you need not to basically use your hand to pull and do that handbrake done or lever up and down. So as soon as you basically pull this button, so your parking brakes are on, and then when you accelerate, it automatically gets off. So that is also very good feature. Then I think if I compare, yeah, I think Seltos also have almost everything. So Seltos has one or two good features which I like and which I wanted, that it should be available in Creta also. So one is 360 degree camera, which is very useful feature in the city driving. When you basically park or drive, it's very useful feature as far as I experienced it. Secondly, I think there is another feature which is also associated with the camera function only, which is a blind spot camera, or blind spot view we call it. So as soon as you turn your indicator left and right, then so Seltos has that on your screen itself. You get to see who is coming from right and left, so you can basically do your driving accordingly. But sometimes when you don't have this camera, then your I think we call these are A-pillars. Yeah, so they create a blind spot when you take a turn. Yeah, so that is something I see as a negative in this vehicle as of now. Second, I think city mileage is also very important thing, because most of the time we drive in city only. So that also has to be improved somehow by Hyundai.
Okay.
Secondly, I forgot to mention that we have another feature in Creta which is not available in Seltos or Jeep Compass, is that we have paddle shifters. So paddle shifter is again a very useful feature when you basically drive this car on the highway. So you will definitely have that kind of situation when you need to overtake other vehicles or you need immediate acceleration. So pedal shifters basically are used to change the gear upward and downward whenever we want. So it basically change your vehicle from auto to manual. So with the click of the buttons, you can basically change your gears. So that is the benefit of pedal shifters. So which is not available in for the matter Seltos or Jeep Compass or any other arch rival. All these luxury cars like Audi, BMW or maybe any other luxury car have these kind of features. So that is a good takeaway from these cars.
So ये आपको काफी बड़ा positive मिला इस गाड़ी में, जो आपको Seltos में भी देखने को
exactly
नहीं
yeah on highway it will be very useful. I'm very much sure. I've not drove that much on highways as of now, considering the situation we are into, but yeah, we'll definitely have that kind of experience. Well,
और ओवरऑल हैंडलिंग एंड स्टीयरिंग कैसा लगा आपको?
सो Hyundai, इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, दे आर नोन फॉर देयर लाइट स्टीयरिंग. समटाइम यू सी दैट दिस लाइट स्टीयरिंग इज यूजफुल, समटाइम यू फील दैट दिस लाइट इज वेरी लाइट, सो इट बेसिकली टर्न योर व्हीकल लेफ्ट राइट. बट व्हाट आई फील्ड इट्स बिट यू वुड से बिट हार्ड देन अदर वर्जन्स ऑफ क्रेटा और अदर मॉडल्स ऑफ Hyundai. So it's bit better than what we had in past. So it's more like it's more or less like Seltos only, because what we know that Seltos has a good steering handling. So we have the similar kind of thing in Creta as well.
So basically, गाड़ी को drive करते आपको ज़्यादा confidence feel होता होगा कि ना तो ज़्यादा light और ना ज़्यादा heavy.
Right. I mean the kind of balance driver need that we are getting it.
ओके फाइन. क्रेटा खरीदने का प्लान कर रहे होंगे लेकिन बहुत ज्यादा कंफ्यूज होंगे कि क्या खरीदा जाए या फिर Seltos की तरफ जाना चाहिए. तो क्या आपको लगता है कि आपकी क्या राय है कि इस गाड़ी को आप रिकमेंड करोगे अदर बॉयज को या फिर नहीं?
या आई थिंक माय रिकमेंडेशन विल गो पॉजिटिव फॉर एनी अदर Hyundai व्हीकल, बिकॉज वी नो दैट Hyundai इज गिविंग दैट काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट एंड क्वालिटी इन देयर प्रोडक्ट्स बेसिकली देयर कार्स. So Creta for the matter, I think it is again started leading the SUV market as soon as it launched with this 2020 version. So you can also see that people are buying this car like any other commodity. So because that kind of impression it has on the road, and then people have that kind of belief in Hyundai. So I feel that people will definitely buy this car over any other competitor. Now if let's say my family will have any other new car, so we'll definitely go with the Hyundai car. We have that kind of belief in the Hyundai. Over a period they have developed that kind of service network as well. So if you see that you get the roadside assistance from any kind of Hyundai authorized dealer or maybe any you say any unorganized kind of auto spare part you get from the market. So you it's not I would say it's not always that you need to buy it from Hyundai only. You have those kind of products available in the market as well from the Hyundai itself. So I think I will definitely recommend Hyundai Creta to any other buyer who is willing to buy SUV car, a city SUV car.
Okay, so friends, ये था Creta Turbo DCT का owner review. अगर आपको वीडियो थोड़ी सी भी अच्छी लगी हो तो लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब करना मत भूलिएगा.
So definitely I will suggest all the YouTube community or the viewers that they definitely subscribe to this channel, because we are getting the content from our city Sirsa, Haryana. So Sachin is doing good coverage of almost every vehicle or every variant. So just encourage our friend, our basically fellow from our city, and yeah, subscribe their channel and like the videos and press the bell icon, we say, yeah, right? Yeah. Press the bell icon. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Ashish. Thank you so much for coming on our channel.
Thanks to your channel.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Bye.